Good morning. Myself Manoj, working as assistant professor in EC department, Chebro Engineering College, Chebrolu. And today's topic is biasing of NPN transistor. So, NPN transistor means here a P-type semiconductor is sandwiched between two N-type semiconductor materials to form a T-terminal transistor, namely NPN transistor, right? And now we have to properly bias the transistor in order to make it work in active region. And of course, there are number of types of biasings, and we have already discussed in our last class, right? Generally, we prefer active mode of operation. Okay, so we are going to bias transistor in active mode. So here, biasing means the controlling of operation of current by providing power supply. The function of both PN junctions is controlled by providing proper bias to circuit to some DC supply. Right? Here, a P-type semiconductor sandwiched between two N-type semiconductor materials to form three-terminal semiconductor device, NPN transistor. Right? I can assume this NPN transistor as two diodes connected back to back, right? This transistor has three terminals, namely emitter, base and collector. And I have two junctions. One junction is between emitter and base, and another junction is between base and collector. The junction between emitter and base is called emitter-base junction and also called input junction. And base and the junction between base and collector is called collector base junction or simply output junction. Okay, so this is biasing of transistor in active mode. Generally, in order to operate transistor in active mode, the input junction, which is the junction between emitter and base, also called junction JE, must be forward biased, and the output junction, which is the junction between base and collector, generally called output junction or JC, must be reverse biased. Whether it may be NPN transistor or PNP transistor, we have to follow this rule. Okay, and in order to make junction forward biased, junction JE forward biased, what I have to do? For a PNP transistor, let us suppose, in PNP transistor, a N-type semiconductor material is sandwiched between two P-type semiconductor substrates. Okay, so here a P-type emitter is connected, P-type material, which is emitter, is connected to positive supply of voltage source, and N-type semiconductor substrate, which is base, is connected to negative terminal of voltage source VEE, such that the input junction is forward biased. This is called input junction. This is called input junction, and it is forward biased. Okay, so here a P-type semiconductor substrate is connected to positive terminal of battery voltage source VEE, and N-type semiconductor substrate, which is base, is connected to negative terminal of battery VEE, such that this PN junction is forward biased. Okay, this PN junction is forward biased. And this is input junction. This is the junction between emitter and base. Okay, and it is forward biased. And I have to make output junction reverse bias. And I have to make output junction reverse bias. This is the output junction. This is the output junction, JC, which is also called JC. It is a junction between base and collector. And I have to make this junction reverse bias so that P-type semiconductor's collector substrate is connected to negative of battery VCC, and N-type semiconductor substrate, which is base, is connected to positive terminal of battery VCC, such that this junction JC will become reverse biased, right? And the direction of currents are as shown in the figure, and I will discuss this direction of currents in current components of NPN and PNP transistors separately in another session. And for NPN transistor, the input junction, which is JE, must be forward biased, and output junction, which is JC, must be reverse biased. So in order to make NPN transistor input junction forward bias, I have to give negative terminal of battery to N-type semiconductor substrate in which is emitter region, and positive terminal of battery is connected to base, which is P-type region, semiconductor substrate region. So it will make junction JE forward bias, and I have to connect N-type semiconductor substrate, which is collector region, to positive terminal of battery, and P-type semiconductor substrate to negative terminal of battery VCC in order to make junction output junction JC reverse bias. Okay. So here now the transistor is said to be operated in active region, and this voltage sources, I'm giving the proper voltage sources, and this is called biasing of a transistor, right? Here I have denoted the voltage sources VEE and VCC in double subscript notation, okay? And this is schematic, and this is equivalent circuit diagram for this schematic, right? And now the N-type material is provided with negative supply, and P-type material is given to positive supply to make circuit forward bias. Always, if N-type semiconductor material is connected to positive terminal of any voltage source, and if P-type semiconductor substrate is connected to negative terminal of voltage source, then this is called reverse bias. So forward bias means I have to connect negative terminal of battery or voltage source to N-type semiconductor substrate, and positive terminal of battery or voltage source to P-type semiconductor substrate. Then this type of biasing is called forward biasing, and the N-type semiconductor material is connected to positive terminal of battery or voltage source, and if P-type material is connected to negative terminal of battery or voltage source, then this type of biasing is called reverse bias, right? By applying the power, the emitter base junction must be always forward biased, as I said now, right? This makes emitter resistance very, very small, right? The collector base junction is reverse biased and its resistance is somewhat higher. So a small forward bias is sufficient at emitter junction, whereas high reverse bias has to be applied to collector junction. The direction of current indicated in the circuit above is called conventional current. This is the movement of hole current, which is opposite to electron current, right? So if the junction is forward biased, then the resistance at this junction will be less. If the junction is reverse biased, then resistance at that junction must be somewhat higher. Okay. So this will make transistor to work in active region. Okay, and now the operation of PNP transistor. Now this is the equivalent circuit diagram which I have shown you earlier. The junction emitter based junction is forward biased and collector based junction is reverse biased. Here in p-type semiconductor substrate, the holes are majority charge carriers and electrons are minority charge carriers. In base region, that is n-type region, electrons are majority charge carriers and holes become minority charge carriers. And again, in p-type semiconductor substrate in collector region, which is collector region, again holes will become majority charge carriers and electrons will become minority charge carriers, right? So make sure the NPN and PNP both transistors are bipolar junction transistors, which means the total current which is produced in the device is a combination of currents due to majority and minority charge carriers. Okay, so here in these transistors we have to consider the flow of current due to majority and minority charge carriers. We have to consider both currents, majority and minority charge carriers. Okay, so here another thing we have to remember is this, that the emitter region is highly doped. The base region is lightly doped and the collector region is moderately doped, means it is also highly doped, but when compared to emitter region, doping in emitter region, the doping in collector region is somewhat less, that's it. But doping concentration in collector region is far greater than the doping concentration in base region. This we have to remember always, right? So, and another thing is, the emitter width is high and base width is very, very less, and that width of collector is much more larger than the width of emitter region. This is because in order to accommodate the electrons coming from emitter region, the collector region width must be higher, right? So when p-type emitter substrate is connected to positive terminal of battery and n-type semiconductor substrate, which is base region, connected to negative terminal of battery to make transistor to work in active region, right? This junction I am now making forward bias, right? So what will happen in p-type semiconductor? Holes are majority charge carriers here and electrons are here minority charge carriers in emitter region. So what will happen? The holes which are majority charge carriers gets repelled due to positive terminal of battery. So the holes will move towards base region. So this is direction of holes. This is the direction of holes, right? And this is the current due direction of holes, right? Make sure that the holes are positive charge carriers, and I am giving here positive supply VEE to p-type region. So what will happen? As like charges repel each other, the holes move towards base region. This is the direction of holes. Always the current due to holes is in direction of flow of holes. So if holes move from p to n region, from emitter to base, then the direction of current is also from emitter to base only due to holes. And here in p region, electrons are here minority charge carriers. So that electrons get attracted towards this positive terminal of battery, VEE. So what will happen? The electrons will move towards positive terminal of battery. So what will be direction of current? direction of current is always opposite to flow of electrons. Means if the electrons move from left to right, then direction of current due to electrons is from right to left, right? If the holes move towards left to right, then direction of current is in the same direction, left to right only. So this is the direction of current due to holes. Why? Because the holes are moving from P region to N region. Therefore, direction of current due to holes is from P to N, same direction, this direction only. And the electrons which are minority charge carriers in P-type region gets attracted towards this VEE. So the electrons move towards VEE like this. So what will happen? The direction of current due to electrons is opposite to direction of flow of electrons. That's why if electron move like this, then current direction is opposite to the flow of electrons. So in emitter region, the total current, this is the current due to holes, and this is the current due to electrons. So the total current, which is the summation of minority majority charge carriers, is from emitter to base at junction JE. This we have to remember. Right? And next thing, at junction JC, what will happen? Means from emitter to base, this is the direction of current. This current is the summation of both electron and hole current. Okay. So, So, let us move on to output junction, which is JC. Here, it is also a P-type semiconductor substrate. Right? And I am now doing reverse bias here. So what will happen? The electrons are here minority charge carriers, and holes are here majority charge carriers in collector region. We all know that, right? So the holes which are majority charge carriers in collector region will be attracted towards negative terminal of battery. So the holes will move towards negative terminal of battery. So what will be the current due to holes? Same direction. This is the current due to holes. And what about the current due to electrons in collector region? As electrons which are minority charge carriers in collector region will be repelled due to this negative supply. So what will happen? Electrons will move towards base. So what will be, Here, direction of current is opposite to flow of electrons. So this is the current direction in collector region. So the total current direction is from emitter to collector. Then what about base? Here in base, electrons are majority charge carriers and holes are minority charge carriers. Here the electrons which are majority charge carriers in n-type substrate will be attracted towards this positive terminal of battery. So what will happen? Electrons will be attracted towards positive terminal of battery. So direction of current is opposite to flow of electrons. Okay. And here holes are minority charge carriers in base. Then holes get repelled due to this positive terminal of battery. So what will happen? Holes will move like this. So in base region, direction of holes is towards upside and direction of electrons is also towards upside. So the total current is entering into base region. Okay, so this is direction of current IE. This is direction of current IB and this direction of current IC. Okay. So again I am telling, this is direction of current IE, this is direction of current IB and this is direction of current IC. That's why for PNP transistor, arrow mark is like this. This is P, this is N, this is P. This is emitter, this is base and this is collector terminal. So arrow mark is from P to N, emitter to base. Chudandi ikkada, the current is flowing from emitter to base. Current is entering into base. Okay. So let us move on to NPN transistor. So here the VE provides a positive potential at emitter which repels the holes in P-type material and holes cross the emitter junction to reach the base region. There are very low percentage of holes recombined with free electrons of N region. This provides a very low current which constitutes base current IB. The remaining holes cross the collector base junction to constitute collector current IC, which is the hole current. As the hole reaches the collector terminal, an electron from the battery negative terminal fills the space in collector region. This flow slowly increases and electron minority current flows through emitter, where each electron entering into positive terminal of VEE is replaced by hole moving towards emitter junction. This constitutes emitter current IE. Hence, the conduction in a PNP transistor takes place through holes. Of course, also electrons, but electrons are here minority charge carriers and holes are majority charge carriers in PNP. Right? And the collector current is slightly less than emitter current. Why? Because emitter is highly doped and collector is lightly doped. The increase or decrease in emitter current affects the collector current. As we know, IE equal to IB plus IC. Okay. Let us move on to NPN transistor. NPN transistor. Okay. Here also, this junction, emitter junction JE is forward biased and collector junction JC must be reverse biased. So here, I'm connecting N-type semiconductor material, which is emitter to negative of battery and P-type base to positive of battery to make JE forward bias. So here, NPN transistor symbol is like this. So here electrons which are majority charge carriers gets repelled due to negative terminal of battery. So electrons move from emitter to base. So therefore, current due to electrons is from right to left like this. And the holes which are minority charge carriers in N-type emitter region gets attracted towards this negative terminal of battery. So what will happen? Current is always in same as the direction of flow of holes. So this is total current IE at emitter region. So current flows from emitter to outside. So this is the symbol. That's why I am putting here arrow outside, right? And here the electrons which are majority charge carriers in collector region gets attracted towards positive terminal of battery. So what will happen? Electrons will move towards positive terminal of battery. Therefore, what is the direction of current? Opposite to flow of electrons. And here the holes which of anti-charge carriers in n-type semiconductor collector region gets repelled due to this positive bluff battery? So what will happen? Holes move like this. So what will happen? Direction of current is from collector to base. So that's why in transistor, this is direction of IE. Current enters into base like this, and current enters from collector to base like this. So these conventions are shown here. Okay. So here also IE equal to IB plus IC. Entering currents is equal to leaving current. Okay. This is entering current IB. This is entering current IC. And this is leaving current IE. Therefore, entering currents must be equal to leaving currents. Therefore, IE equal to IB plus IC. Okay. So again, IE equal to IB plus IC must be satisfied here also. Right. And now, excuse me. Here, the VE provides negative potential at the emitter, which repels electrons in n-type semiconductor material. And these electrons cross the emitter base junction to reach the base region. There are a very low percent of electrons recombined with free holes of P region. This provides very low current, which constitutes the base current IB. The remaining holes cross the collector base junction to constitute collector current IC. As an electron reaches out of the collector terminal and enters the positive terminal of battery, an electron from negative terminal of battery VEE enters into emitter region. This flow slowly increases and electron current flows through the transistor. Therefore, for NPN transistor, conduction takes place majority due to electrons, and holes are here minority charge carriers. The collector current is higher than emitter current. Okay, and the increase or decrease in the emitter current affects the collector current also, as IE equal to IB plus IC. So let us move on to working of NPN transistor, which is unbiased. Unbiased means I am not going to apply any voltage source. So this is the schematic. When no voltage is applied to a transistor, it is said to be unbiased transistor. Here I am not applying any voltage source to. Emitter and base, and also collector to base. I am not giving any supplies like this. Okay. So here, when no voltage is applied to transistor, it is said to be unbiased transistor. The left side N region, which is emitter, and right side N region, which is collector, free electrons are majority charge carriers, as I said now, and holes are minority charge carriers. Whereas in base region, holes are majority charge carriers and electrons are the minority charge carriers, right? We know that charge carriers always try to move from higher concentration region to lower concentration region. Here in n-type region, electrons are majority charge carriers, and in this base, which is p-type region, electrons are minority charge carriers. So electron tends to move from high concentration area to low concentration area. Likewise, here also electrons are here majority charge carriers, and electrons are here minority charge carriers. Therefore, electrons from n-side collector region also tends to move towards p region. Why? Because in p region, the concentration of electrons is much more lower. So this process is called diffusion. Diffusion means the electrons move from or holes, anything, any charge carriers, if they move from high concentration area to low concentration area under no external energy supplied, that is called diffusion. So electrons, which are majority charge carriers in n-type region, which is emitter and also collector regions, move towards base region, which is p-type semiconductor material. As in p-type semiconductor base material, electrons are minority charge carriers, right? Similarly, for holes, p region is higher concentration region and n region is the lower concentration region. So vice versa, the concept is vice versa. Therefore, the free electrons at the left side of n region and right side of n region experience repulsive force from each other. As a result, the free electrons at the left side and right side n regions will move towards p-type base region. The electrons will move from emitter to base and also collector to base. Okay. And now, the holes which are majority charge carriers in p-type region will move from base to emitter and also base to collector. Okay. So during this process, the free electrons in n-type regions at the left side of n-region emitter and right side of n-region collector experience a repulsive force from each other. As a result, free electrons at left side and right side n-regions move towards base region. Okay. So the free electrons meet holes in p-type base near the junction and fill the base. Means when electron move from emitter region to base region, electrons are majority charge carriers here in emitter region and holes majority charge carriers in base region. When electron finds a hole, the recombination takes place. Then what will happen? They both neutralize. Okay, electron from emitter region or collector region will enter into base region. So what will happen? The electron replace holes. Okay, so recombination takes place. So we are left with immobile ions. Okay, each negative ion has one positive hole. And here, each positive ion have negative electron here. Okay. So what will happen? When electron finds hole here, they both will recombine. Then uncovering of ions takes place and a depletion region will be formed here. Okay. So as a result, depletion region is formed at emitter to base junction and base to collector junction. Right? So at emitter to base junction, depletion region is penetrated more towards base side. Similarly, at base to collector junction, depletion region is penetrated toward base side. Penetrated more towards base side. So at emitter to base junction, the depletion region is penetrated more towards base side. So you can see in this figure, this depletion region will penetrate more towards base side. And also from collector region also, the depletion region is penetrated more towards base side. Right? So this is because emitter to base junction, emitter is heavily doped and base is lightly doped. So depletion region is penetrated more towards base side and less towards emitter side. Similarly, at the base to collector junction, the collector is heavily doped than base and base is lightly doped. So the depletion region penetrated more towards base side and less towards collector side. The collector region is lightly doped. As we know, it is discussed in the construction of transistor itself. So the collector region is lightly doped than emitter region. So the depletion region width at the collector side is more than depletion region width at emitter side, at emitter side. Okay, so make sure that the depletion region penetrate more towards lightly doped side than heavily doped side. Okay, so depletion region penetrates more towards lightly doped side than the heavily doped side, right? And now at emitter base junction, let us assume that left side N region, which is emitter, each atom has 3 free electrons, and at P region each atom has 1 hole. So during diffusion process, electrons move from emitter to base junction. Similarly, holes move towards base to emitter region, as I said now. So the depletion region width at junction JE is less than depletion region width at junction JC. Okay, this is what we get under no bias condition. Okay, under no bias condition. And now I am biasing transistor. Okay. So biased NPN transistor, right? I'm now biasing transistor. So I told you junction JE is forward biased and junction JC must be reverse biased, and the voltage source symbols are as shown according to active bias, right? Let us consider in this figure emitter base is forward biased by DC voltage VEE, which is double subscript notation, and collector base junction is reverse biased by DC voltage VCC, right? So due to forward bias at junction JE, a large number of free electrons in left side N region experience a repulsive force from the neutral terminal of DC battery, and also they experience an attractive force from positive terminal of battery VCC. Right? As a result, the free electrons start flowing from emitter to base. In a similar way, the holes in base experience a repulsive force from positive terminal of battery VEE, and also experience attractive force from neutral terminal of battery VCC. As a result, holes start flowing from base to emitter. Okay, here, the electrons which are magnetic charge carriers get repelled due to neutral terminal of battery, and electron move towards base. And holes which are majority charge carriers in base region gets repelled due to this positive terminal of battery, and holes move towards emitter side. So what will happen? Recombination takes place, and at junction depletion region is formed. Okay, due to the apparent external voltage, each emitter atom has more than 1 or 2 free electrons. Hence, each emitter atom donates more than 1 or 2 free electrons to more positive ions. As a result, positive ions becomes neutral. Similarly, each base atom accepts more number of electrons from more negative ions. As a result, negative ions becomes neutral. We know that depletion region is nothing but combination of positive and negative ions. So what will happen? A depletion region is formed, and the depletion width at base emitter junction reduces by applying forward bias. Okay, if we apply forward bias, the depletion region width greatly reduces. If I increase forward bias much more, then what happens? The depletion region width at junction JE reduces drastically. So one thing we have to remember, if the depletion region width is reduced, what will happen? Resistance at that junction must be reduced. Okay, if depletion region width reduces, what will happen? the resistance at that junction will be reduced. Okay, so the representation width at emitter base junction reduces by applying forward bias voltage VE. As electric current means flow of charge carriers, the free electrons flow from emitter to base, whereas holes move from base to emitter. These charge carriers conduct electric current. Okay, however the conventional current direction is same as direction of holes, and current due to electrons is opposite to the flow of direction of electrons. Thus basic electric current will flow from base to emitter. So what will happen at base collector junction? Due to reverse bias, a large number of free electrons at right side N region experiences an attractive force from positive terminal of battery. Hence, the free electrons move away from the junction and flow towards positive terminal of battery. As a result, large number of neutral collector atoms loses electrons and becomes positive ions. On the other hand, the holes in P region, which is base, experience an attractive force from negative terminal of battery. Hence, holes move away from the junction and flow towards negative terminal of battery. As a result, a large number of neutral base atoms gains electrons and becomes immobile ions here. Thus, the width of depletion region increases at collector base junction. Okay, so the depletion region width JE is less than the depletion region width at JC. Why? Because of biasing here, right? So the number of positive and negative ions increases at base collector junction. So what will happen? The free electrons that are flowing from emitter to base due to forward bias will combine with holes in base. However, base is very thin now, right? The base width is reduced by a great extent. Why? Because of these depletion regions. Okay. So what will happen? The base is very, very thin and it is lightly doped when compared to emitter and collector regions. So what will happen? Even if electrons move from emitter to base, it will not recombine with all the holes present in base. Why? Because it is lightly doped. And another thing is, the base width is very, very thin. So therefore, very less number of electrons will recombine with holes in base region, and large number of electrons will move towards collector region. Okay. So only a small percentage of emitter electrons combines with holes in base region. The remaining large number of free electrons from emitter region will cross the base region and reaches the collector region. This is due to positive supply voltage applied to collector. Hence, free electrons flows from emitter to collector. At collector, both the emitter free electrons and collector free electrons produces current by flowing towards positive terminal of battery. Therefore, an amplified current is produced at the output here, right? In NPN transistor, electric current is majorly due to free electrons. Of course, magnetic charge carrier current will also have to consider. Okay, so the main concept IE equal to IB plus IC must be satisfied here also. Okay, so this is all for today's lecture. See you in next class.